I pray that, Lord, you'd minister to us this morning. And so we bless and we honor you. And as we give and release ourselves to you, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Good morning to all of us this morning. Karibuni sana. Donna, it's good to see you. Let's consider day 20. Our scripture is in John chapter 13, verse 34 to 35. A new command I give unto you, that you love one another. As I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another, if you have love one to another. Today we want to focus on showing love. There is love and showing love. And just to check what is in our manual this morning, the Bible talks quite a lot about the issue of judging, judging one another quite a lot. The attitude and the spirit and the heart of judgmentalism. And it's very easy to point out the speck. The speck is a small chip in your wood in my brother's eye, my sister's eye, and forget that there is a protruding beam in my own eye. Jesus used this example to show, literally you cannot have a log in your eye, but he was using this example to show how grievous the matter is. And one of the things that people in search for really had today in any community of people is genuine love. Is genuine love, love that that cares. I'm doing a study on angels, especially because of the sermon that we are walking through on the war. And I realized that even to date, the holy angels, they do not attack the person of the wicked angels. And they convey the message, if there's a message to be conveyed, and they go back. They do not attack their person, much as they know that they are fallen, they are working against Creator or the maker of the universe. It's one thing to confront a wrong issue in people's lives and people's heart and their behavior, but it's another thing to attack the person of people and reduce them to the wrong they do. Yesterday we were talking about fear, and we said perfect love casts out fear. There needs to be a growing of our love. Extend that our love is always greater when we have to deal with issues, some of the issues that are very serious issues within our human relations, within our human relationships, whether it's at home with our siblings, with our parents, with our children, with our cousins, with our sisters and brothers. Love needs to be to grow so much. One of the things that I love so much is in the statement that we do not handle people and love issues. Issues will always come up. And when an issue comes up that affects the family of believers, that affects a relationship of believers, that affects you and affects your relationship to someone closer to you, one of the things that we need to learn is issues will always be there. And we should not be issue lovers, but we should always love people. We should love people and handle issues, not love issues and handle people. So it's very easy to keep on being in a position of fault finding. And instead of doing that, it's good to point people to Jesus. He knows our hearts, he knows their hearts. And of course, we are living in a wicked and fallen world today. So people will do things intentionally, but even then, it's for us to exercise love, even when we need to confront things that are not okay, that are not right. Matthew chapter 7, verse 4 is what forms the basis of, I know you can approach love in so many ways, but today we are approaching love from a place of seeing the best in people. The Bible says, if God is to count our iniquities, we cannot stand before him. So what does it mean to take the plank out of your own eye? In his great Sermon on the Mount, Jesus Christ sometimes employed a literally tool to make a point. Scholars will call that hyperbole, and he would use that to make a point. And in this example, Jesus asks a question. Why do you look at the speck of sawdust in your brother's eye and pay attention, no attention, to the plank in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, let me take out your out of your eye, out, let me take the speck out of your eye, when all the time there's a plank in your own eye? Stress when all the time is really key. You hypocrite, first take the plank out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. So Jesus is drawing a very brilliant word picture of someone who is trying to be sensitive with the business of extracting a tiny speck of sawdust from their friend's eye, from their colleague, from their spouse, sometimes from people around them, from their brother, sister in the Lord. And as they do that, in contrast, a sizable piece of wood, some versions will even say a log, is in that person's eye. And this piece of wood is completely obstructing their vision. And it's impossible for me to take off a piece of sawdust from Purity's eye when I cannot see. And what obstructs my vision is what is in my eye. probably, maybe, and more often, the bad we see in people, it's because our vision of them is obstructed by our own inefficiencies and deficiencies. It's evident that Jesus was not speaking literally here. And he was using this exaggeration to drive home the truth that people are often blind. We are often blind to our own faults, while at times we find ourselves keenly on weakness in others. And the Lord put a burden in my heart about knowing God, finding freedom, discovering purpose and making a difference. The first thing that deals with us is our ability to get closer to God and getting to connect with him and to know him. The second one, I think, is the most important of all human relations, and that is in finding freedom. All of us have heart issues to deal with. Our heart issues have to do with our past. Each one of us has a past here. But time and again, this past looks like and seems like is catching up with us. We have heart issues that have to do with pain. And pain can be a blessing, but we have heart issues that have to deal with pain. Finding ourselves in some quarters that we never signed for, but we have to deal with that. And then all of us have heart issues that have to deal with people. Some of the people that have been in our lives are not the best. Some of the experiences that we've had to go through people can be really difficult. And in the bracket of people coming together, people come with their histories, people come with their current affairs, people come with their future projections, and people still want to come and close ties and be brothers and sisters and walk together in heaven. The only way we can walk together in heaven is when we acknowledge and accept that as brothers come together, they do not just come as worshipers, but they come together also as deficient and struggling human beings. And when we have that view, then it's easy for us. I'm literally unable kufinya kaleka kitu kwa sababu we have overload and Njabi is not working on this thing. Okay. So when others come together and sisters, and if they can only agree and accept that one of the reasons that we came together is not just to worship together, but is to build one another, it would be very easy for us then to exercise love. Because love, the Bible says, love covers a multitude of sin. And this morning, we are not talking about love. We are talking about showing love, extending love. To show love is more true biblically when there is nothing on the other end that looks like love deserving. And that's what the Lord did with us. And one of the dreadful things, one of the things that the Lord hates so much in the scriptures is the misuse of tongue. Misuse of tongue. Why people would uncover, why people would withhold help from others, most of the time is because of how you perceive the other person. It's what, not even just you perceive, maybe it's what you truthfully know about the other person. Yet, even in your full knowledge of what is wrong, what is not right, what is questionable with the other person, the scriptures, the Bible calls us to exercise love, to show love. And this morning, as we pray and as we seek the Lord, I want you to take some stock, some self-evaluation, and look around you. How is it going with maybe people that God will put in your heart? Who are you unable to show love, extend help because of some deficiencies that they have? And would the Lord allow you maybe to know the reason why you get to be in the circles of these people, whether it is family, whether it is in the office, whether it is the marketplace, whether it's in the history or in the current, whether it's in a church like ours? Could the Lord maybe open your hearts to know probably that you are overlooking of their fault and extending grace, help, and whatsoever else that the Lord is causing you, probably is what is needed for these people to be set on a new path of growing in this particular area. Or maybe probably it's only a speck that you see and your vision is blurred by the plank, the log that is in your own eye, in my own eye. I know they are heavy words, but it's what showing love takes. The woman caught in adultery early in the morning in the book of John, chapter 8, you can consider that, was brought before Jesus. Truthfully, the Bible uses this word in James' version. I don't have a Bible close by, but it says that she was caught in the very act of adultery. They did not suspect. They did not see her walk out of some door. It was in the very act of adultery. They brought her to Jesus. The law said such a woman was to be stoned to death. That's one of the laws of the Moses that I think is, I had a problem with it, because, I mean, she was not in the act of adultery alone, because a majority here are ladies. You need to know that I always support you. So they brought her to Jesus. And that day, these guys expected to have a stone in either way. If Jesus said, stone her, they would stone her to death. If Jesus said, don't stone her, they would stone Jesus because he breaks. So either way, walikuja wata kama mafans wa God, watu wakona tumawe kwa mfuko. And what did Jesus do? Jesus confronted the same issue by telling the scribes and Pharisees, any one of you that is without sin, any one of you that doesn't have a log, if you're log-free, such as you want us to punish the speck issue of this woman, be the first one. Jesus was not excusing the woman's sin, but he was pointing out the need for consistency, consistency of word and life and behavior, honesty, humility when passing judgment. Passing judgment, I think, is a very high standard because it requires that you be above reproach, and not just in this particular area, in any other issue. The Lord wants us to be reminded this morning that this blade of judgment cuts both ways. When we judge others, we condemn ourselves as well. If we are not willing to evaluate ourselves honestly and accurately, then we'll undermine our right to scrutinize the lives of others. Do not judge, or you too will be judged, are the words of Jesus. I know this could be an extensive topic that I will leave hanging, and my emphasis this morning is not on the need of us correcting each other in love. That one is very important. Correcting one another in love is a biblical instruction. It's an admonishment that we've been given. But it's not the same as judging, because judging others is seeing their wrong, not approaching them, and withholding help from them, or going behind their back to speak about that speck that we see. And that one is one of the greatest distractors of us walking in brotherly love and care. The world is dying for true love. Churches are dying. They are in search. People in church, but they're in search of true love. Let me show you something and finish. Anybody that came to Jesus, the first question that Jesus ever asked, first expression, was not on who they are. First, he accepted them as they were. And that's the mandate of us as believers, that people will first, you know, you cannot show love to a person that already feels rejected. It's not possible. So love says, come as you are, but don't remain as you are. Help them walk through transformation. And that's what the Lord has done with us. Come as you are, Kimani. Do not remain as you are. Daily transform, work on your salvation. And as that happens, then I'm experiencing his love, but I'm also on a growth track. So Lord, we thank you this morning. We are so deficient of love. We do not know what love is. Everything you do, everything you will ever do, finds its root in your deep love. You are love. And I pray that today, would you illuminate the corners of our hearts where we need, Lord, to truly not just walk in love, but to honestly, consistently show love. Maybe love is to that person that doesn't know you, that contrarily works against what is your will. Maybe the love that you want us to exercise today is to that person that, Lord, offends us so intentionally. Maybe the love that you want us to exercise this morning is that love to a fellow brother and sister. Is there any area of our lives where we are withholding help? And it's because maybe there's something we see wrong on the other end that we would rather de-associate ourselves. I pray this morning that you'd open up our hearts and our minds in the name of Jesus. And Father, even as we almost come to a close of this season of Daniel fast, I pray that one among many other things that we will walk in this year is walk in love, that we may be a true demonstration of love in action. Even when it's difficult and heavy, it's possible because you give us the grace. So this morning, I speak your blessings over us, over the Washiras, over Donna, over Joyce, over the Kimanis, and over Kinoti. I pray that, Father, you'd cause for us to cherish and hold this really close to our hearts. So blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus. We honor and bless you, and our day is blessed. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord minister to you, minister his grace to you. And I commend you to his same grace that is able to keep you and sustain you from falling, from stumbling, and to cause you to walk in fruitfulness and to walk in love. In Jesus' name we pray. Can I mute and say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just unmute, remain unmuted, and then we can share the words of praise. The Lord bless you. And, see us in the tomorrow. But again, and now may the grace.
Thanks. The love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, forevermore.
Amen. No, but again.